wants to enlighten us and tell us who that is.
That is Sidney Lawrence. He's quite a famous Alaskan artist, although he came from England. Made quite a life for himself here. My husband's great aunt was a friend of his. And that's how this picture got into our family.
I'm going to correct you on one thing there.
Okay.
It was almost the opposite of England.
Oh, it was?
Brooklyn.
Brooklyn? He came from
Brooklyn, born and bred.
Oh.
1865, yes. But you're almost right, because he spent about 15 years in England.
Oh, okay.
He was there at the time with a wife and two children. And then he, pulled a gogan and disappeared.
Mm.
And came to Alaska around about 1903, 1904.
Okay.
And he was a gold prospector at that time. Quite a colorful character, because about before he was doing that, he was in Africa.
Oh, wow.
During the Boer War. He was a wartime correspondent and artist.
Oh.
So he covered the Boer War. He was in China during the Boxer Rebellion. And also in Africa, he covered the Zulu Wars. And in fact, got clubbed, which led to him losing hearing in one ear.
Oh, wow.
So he had quite a colourful life, as I say. But circumstance or choice led him to Alaska. He was the first professional artist to really set up stall here. And this is one that he did here. He was in Anchorage from about 1920 onwards. The frame here appears to be original to me, particularly with the label in the back.
Yeah.
Clearly the artist's label. Indian Fish Cash, Sidney Lawrence, Anchorage, Alaska. And then right down here, slightly less visible, Dolly Crawford, 1922. And tell me about Dolly Crawford.
She was my mother-in-law's mother's sister. So she was his great aunt. And she came to Anchorage. I don't know a lot about her. She came to Alaska and lived here for quite a long time.
So do you know whether this was inherited within the family or was it
given to Dolly? Yes. It was given to Dolly, and then it went through part of her family, and they didn't live in Alaska at that time, and my mother-in-law loved the picture, and she bought it from them.
Oh,
but I don't know how much she paid or anything like that. It was quite a long time ago.
And of course, he was really famous for the paintings he did of Mount McKinley or Denali.
Yes, those are beautiful.
There's enormous snowscapes, so this isn't quite that.
No.
But this is another subject. Can you tell us what this is?
This is a cache, and it's what was used to store food and things like that to keep the animals from getting them.
And we see the fish, the smoked fish, I presume, here?
Yep.
And this would be done in the springtime, looking at the colors. It's got a lovely, like, tonality to it. Mm-hmm. Some of his works could be quite dark. And I love just the little flourishes of brushwork that he's done, and the flowers that you see here, the little dashes of paint that he's used to describe those. You don't see fish caches many places,
no.
But I think just over in the distance there, this one, actually. And have you given any thought to the value of it?
Well, my husband said he thinks it's worth $25,000, and I said, he wanted to know what I thought. I go, I have no idea at all.
Is he quite an optimistic fellow?
Yes, I thought he was.
At auction, I believe it would make somewhere in the region of $8,000 to $12,000.
Mm-hmm.
And if you wanted to insure it,
mm-hmm.
I would suggest around about $20,000.
Okay.
So it's not too far off.
No. Well, I was wondering about that, because it's not insured.
Yeah. You ought to have it insured.
Yeah.
It's a lovely painting.